I want to thank God for you joining me today. As you begin to connect today, I want to thank God for your life. I want to bless God for you, whatever country of the world where you've been connecting today. I want to thank God for being a partaker of the Strategy Prayer Room. As you come into this life-transforming prayer session every day, God bless you as you come in today. I want to thank God for you connecting me with the Strategy Prayer Room. And as you come today, I know that God that you come to seek, he will answer all the petitions of your heart in the mighty name of Jesus. And your prayer life above all things will never remain the same in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm not a medical expert. I am a preacher. You know, I am concerned about the health of your physical body. My concern is your state of your soul. I have good news for you. There's a cure for man's greatest ill. Sin has affected everyone. Everyone has been affected with sin. The world is full of darkness because the world is full of sin. Your sin is sick, whether you know it or not. There is a cure. Jesus said this, "For this is how God loved the world. He gave his one and only Son, and begotten Son, whoever believes in him would not perish, but have eternal life. Whoever you are and what have you done today, God loves you. He loves you. He sent his only Son to save you." But what does Jesus is saying today? Why do you need the Savior? The Bible says that all has sinned, and every single one of us, not just one, but all of us, we all done things. Everyone has sinned. We fall short for the all have sinned. So what do you need to know about what we do about sin? Do we do good deeds? Feeling bad cleanses from the wrongdoing. The Bible says this, no one is righteous. No, not even one. In other words, there's not much we can do to save ourselves. Even if you spent the whole entire life doing good, whether you dedicate your life just cause, even if you was to show kindness to all for the rest of your life, you still fall short of God's holy standards. Furthermore, all who have sinned will be punished for their sins. The Bible says, for the wages of sin is death. The free gift of God is eternal in Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Some might say, because if a man falls, judge the punishment. Cry out for justice. When it comes to our states, we expect mercy. God will judge sin because he's a good judge, because he's a good God. God will punish every wrong, words, thoughts, and deeds. The punishment for sin is death. The punishment for sin is hell. The sins of the world are piling up. And because you're stubborn and refuse to turn from your sin, you're storing up terrible punishment for yourself. For a day of anger is coming when God's righteous judgments will be revealed. I know that's offensive, and it's not my goal to be offensive. No, I take pleasure in sharing the reality with you. But the Bible teaches us, and there's no debate. And no, I don't want a reason. The reason people are offended by the idea of hell, because they're not offended enough by their sins, your own sins. We all fight by the short of Gordy or God. The punishment fit the crime. The judge doesn't let the murderer go because he does the good deeds. In other words, God lets you go because your good deeds. Now, here's the good news. God is also merciful. His holiness punishes sin, but his mercy forgives sinners. And God rescued you will also holy to his holy standards. God came to earth as a man, the God-man, Jesus Christ. Jesus lived a perfect life. He never sinned. And then he died on a cross for your sins. He took your place. He took your punishment. He satisfied the holiness of God. You can save yourself even as you try for 1,000 years. So God had to rescue you. And that your God paid it for you. Fight with other men. The way to salvation is simple. If you openly declare you may be saved. Leave your heart. You are saved. Today, an evil way. So pick up all this offer, and God said to you, come now, let's settle this. Though your sins are like scarlet, I will make them as white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, I will make them as white as wool. He gave you the gift of life. He doesn't ask a hard thing of you. Seek God while there's still time. Exchange selfishness for his love. Your sins for his righteousness. Your guilt for his peace. The gospel is simply this. Jesus was giving eternal life in exchange for your temporary one. If you're ready to give your life to the Lord right now, I want to lead you in a prayer. And I need you to hear me. It's very important. The prayer is not what saves you. There's not magic words you can just pray and be saved. It's not even in the Bible. Prayer never saved souls. Only Jesus saves souls. So I'm guiding you with the words as you surrender to the word. It's between you and the Lord. If you truly repent of your sins, if you sincerely ask for his forgiveness, God will respond. And that's, as we go before God today, he's watching you right now and he's listening. And say it today. Say, dear Lord Jesus, I come to you as a sinner. I admit that I have sinned. I admit that I've done wrong. I admit that I can't save myself. I'm asking you today, forgive me of my sins, Lord. Say it to the Lord, Jesus, I believe you are the Son of God. I believe you died on a cross for my sins. And I believe you rose again from the dead today. I humble myself today, asking you to save me, to change me. I turn from my sin today. By faith right now, now and forevermore, I belong to you, Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ. And I want you to say and type it, amen. And if you spoke that prayer today and you done made a greatest decision in your life, go now, serve the Lord and walk in holiness and turn from your sin and grow spiritually. I'd like to invite you to become a member today with the Strategy Prayer Room. It's an online strategy prayer room. There's a lot of members in our community. And if you join the strategy prayer room, you receive from me a teaching from the Word of God. And I will help you grow in Christ Jesus. And you get a monthly newsletter from us. And you always reply to that email for prayer support. Join the strategy prayer room. If you'd like to know the information of joining the strategy prayer room, the information in the description box. And I thank God for you joining me. And I bless God for you making that commitment today and giving your life over to the Lord. Make